want to share with you, yeah, and your family, family, the love of Jesus Christ,
Jesus Christ.
So tune in,
tune in,
and we will grow together to increase our faith with God, with
One Touch Ministries.
We're touching hearts and changing lives.
Thank you. Because God said, I want the real Deborah to stand up. I want the real. To move into a home, a house. You know, it's very very big, and I received so much furniture from my mom, and she gifted me so much beautiful furniture, and that furniture became very near and dear to my heart. It got so bad that I just did not want anybody sitting on certain sofas, and I didn't want my family to enjoy the furniture because I was afraid of it getting messed up. And a lot of times as women, when we don't have much and God blesses us with something, we hold it so near and dear to our hearts, and it becomes something of importance to us. And I'm speaking of material.
Yeah.
I'm speaking of material. So the furniture that I had was so near and dear to my heart. And as a mother, I took care of it. I made sure, you know, we didn't put stains on the sofas, and I made sure I was cleaning the house to make sure things were in order. But I didn't realize I was idolizing the furniture.
My God.
I didn't realize I was idolizing my material things. I didn't realize it, because when you are used to having and you get, when you're used to having taken away from you, and then you become poor to become rich again, it's like, oh my God, I don't want anybody to take this from me. So when I got the furniture, I mean, I designed, my house was beautiful. I designed it so well. You know, I decorated it so well. But I was like holding on to everything. And I never forget, I had this gold furniture. I had two gold love seats and a gold sofa. And it was beautiful, beautiful, beautiful gold furniture. And it was expensive furniture. And it was handed down to me by my mother. And matter of fact, it was about 40-something years old. But it was beautiful and it was well kept. And I called myself keeping the tradition alive.
Yeah.
I called myself keeping the dream alive, keeping the vision alive, keeping what was given to me a legacy.
Yeah.
If you will, if you want to use that word. I was calling it keeping the legacy alive, because my father sat on that sofa. My mother sat on that sofa. I had so many memories from that sofa. That sofa meant something to me. It was so significant to me.
Yeah.
And it would hurt me if somebody abused that furniture. It would hurt me if somebody sat on it the wrong way.
My God.
And it got to a point where my family just would not use the furniture, wouldn't sit on the furniture, wouldn't even enjoy the furniture. And I got to a point in my life that I was really okay with that. And that brought me more joy, them not touching the furniture, than them using the furniture. I'm going somewhere with this, y'all. I done hooped and hollered in it. You a little something. Let me teach you something about idolizing. Let me teach you about mothers idolizing. Sometimes you have mothers that idolize children, especially when your child is cute.
Well.
Especially when you have a baby that is beautiful, with a beautiful full head of hair, and it's curly, and her lips look just right, and his lips look just, he's handsome, he's such a cute baby. You have mothers who have newborns, and they idolize these newborns.
Yeah.
Because they're so cute, and all the other friends got ugly babies. I'm just being real. Come on, y'all. Let's just be real.
Yeah.
I was idolizing this furniture. This furniture became so important to me. I mean, daughter laughed. I laughed about it too. But deep down inside, I was upset because I was just like, y'all have no clue. I lost everything and then God allowed me to have it back. See, sometimes when you're idolizing things, you put God in front of the idolized. You'll put his name in front of the idolized.
My God.
But it's really not God. And I would just be like, God gave me back my furniture. God gave me back my riches. And that's how I looked at it. Because there was a season where I had riches, and then I lost my riches. And then it was like God was giving me back my riches, and that's what I was looking at. He was giving it back to me. And I wanted to show him that I was so grateful.
My God.
I wanted to show him that I was so grateful for the gift that he gave back to me. But how many of you know that it really wasn't a gift that he gave back? He was testing me. We're going through a test. Sometimes us mothers are so caught up in being mothers that we don't see a test. We don't see a pretext to go into a test. God was pretesting me. He was pretesting me, meaning he was giving me a small snippet of what he was getting ready to test me in to see if I would pass. And I failed.
Wow.
Because the obsession of protecting my furniture, keeping my house a certain way, super clean, was just overbearing. It became overwhelming for my family. It became overwhelming for my husband.
Well.
Because he was like, honey, I didn't have a problem with you cleaning. Then my husband you through a test and you're still failing. Nydetra, I got to break you all the way down. When I tell you God broke me, he allowed the spirit of mold. The spirit of mold come into my home.
Jesus.
It got so bad when I knew, when I got ready to leave, once we got things situated, we left, I realized then that there was, it was for me. It wasn't for nobody else in the household. Walls. space. And all of a sudden it turned into mold. And before you knew it, the mold got a hold of all of my furniture. Before you knew it, it got a hold of all of my beds. Before you knew it, it got a hold of all of my clothes. Before you knew it, the mold was everywhere. It got so bad that it was eating at my skin.
My God. Jesus. Hallelujah. Father God, I pray for the woman of God right now, Lord, that she'll continue to release the things of God, of the voice of God, every single thing that God has empowered her to be able to be released in the name of Jesus. Go ahead.